Hi all. Today we'll see why we are using JSX in the React development. So this is .app.js file. Before that, I have created this project using create React app CLI. So once after creating this, I have removed all the default things and just kept, for simplicity, I have kept one div with two paragraph elements, like why we use JSX. So this is our topic today. So in .js, like in a JavaScript file, we'll be writing our JavaScript code, whereas the HTML code will be writing in .html file. But if you see, there is some strange thing here, like we have wrote the HTML code in the same JavaScript file itself. So this is called as JSX. Whatever we have wrote here is called as JSX. So what is this and why we are using this? So exactly, in JavaScript terms, JavaScript in a browser can't understand the high level program like modern ES6 or TypeScript or JSX. The browsers can't understand these type of things. Browsers can only understand the plain JavaScript code, plain HTML, CSS, and plain JavaScript. Browser can understand only this. So in between our code and the browser, there will be some transpilers like here the Babel. Babel is nothing but a transpiler where it transpiles our modern ES6 code or JSX code into the browser understandable plain JavaScript code. Here Babel js.io, and I have clicked the try it out. So here I will copy paste the code which we have done here, the same function as this. So see, if I copy paste this function, I mean we are writing the code in this manner, the Babel is converting that into like this. So this is the reason. And also the JSX, we are using this JSX in order to convert the HTML elements into React elements. So this is the reason we have imported React here, but we are not using React anywhere in the code, but it will be used internally. So for example, here the Babel is converted our code into like this, like react.create element div. So our code was converted in this manner. So here the p is a p tag, null is nothing but the class name which we use. So in the upper div you can see the class name app. So if you any class name we are using, that class name will be going as a second parameter, and the third parameter is a child. I mean in between whatever the parameter consists of, like a paragraph consists of, that child element will be going here as a third parameter. So in this way the Babel will be converting. So this is the reason we are importing React at the top. So even though we are not using it manually, the Babel is consuming it and it is using to convert the HTML tags into the React elements. So this is the main reason we are going to use JSX. So we use JSX because it will be converting our HTML tags into the React elements. Without JSX also we can develop the React applications, but for that we need to write this many lines of code. Like for every line we need to write react.create element div, so the parent, and then we need to open a brace and need to give the second parameter the class name, and the third parameter would be the remaining elements as children, and for the second element we need to give react.create element p tag and the class name and its childs. So in that way we need to write a redundant code. Even though without using JSX also we can write, but the code would be this much larger. As on when we increase the code, it would be increasing. So it's better to use JSX. The Babel will be converting the JSX code into the plain JavaScript object. So in order our browser to understand, it will be converting that. So the finally, whatever we wrote here, it would be coming here. And also here I mentioned import React from. So we are importing React and we are not using that React. So the Babel is internally, it is converting that. So that's it. Thanks. Thanks a lot.